Alright, so I'm really in a hurry. They're moving really fast tonight. You know that new enemy I mentioned? It's me. Well, it's not really me. To be exact, it's my physical remainings from back in 1993. Yeah, I've been here for a while, if you couldn't guess by my knowledge of these ghosts. This character's gonna send you a voicemail onto your computer's e-phone client, and if you don't delete it fast enough, the computer will autoplay it and probably cause him to find you really quickly. However, the hard thing about this is that deleting these voicemails requires a password. To find the password, switch to the camera that contains the purple curtains. It's camera 4. There's gonna be a sign in there once the message reaches you, and this displays the password, which you quickly need to type in. The e-phone autoplay gives you some time, but there's something that doesn't. The reason the curtains are pushed aside is that the character is in there and is going to begin making his way to your office once the message reaches you. If you're in front of the computer or doors in the general area when he reaches your room, you're fox food. So be really quick about typing in the password and instantly go to the other side of the room so he doesn't see you when he comes to look for you. And never look into camera 3 when he's out. Okay, now that the important stuff to your survival is out of the way, I'm going to explain my plan. If you've been listening to the tapes you've collected, they include recordings of yourself and your friends, and him as well. These obviously aren't real recordings, but instead memories of your messed up childhood compressed into physical form. My idea is that collecting all these may allow you and your friends to move on from purgatory and become free ghosts. Basically, facing your past would make you get over it, make you find your peace. So, for your sake, find all of them. Talk to you later.
Maybe sometime you can check inside those suits in the back room.